day one, and in the pool, China dominated. It was Yang Shuangshui diving to victory from the 1 meter springboard. She'd repeat her gold medal performance from Kazan, edging out the Korean diver Nami Kim. And in the men's 3 meter springboard, Peng Jianfeng dominated to lock down China's second gold. Altogether, China won 8 events out of the 11. In the men's synchronized 3 meter springboard, though, two brothers, Evgeny and Vyacheslav Novoselov, snatched the gold on the last dive, beating Yuming Zong and Yanan Li, Korea taking the bronze. The Russian brothers, relieved after their performance. After our last dive, I didn't want to look at the results straight away, but when I saw that we were first, I couldn't believe it. It was a dream come true, a victory at the Universiade. I'm so happy. The Canadians Caroline Ware and Selena Jane Toth had only a few days to train before the synchronized 10-meter platform event. Selena, a psychology student competing in synchronized diving for the first time, but they took it a dive at a time, and their confidence grew.
With the little amount of practice that we've had, we basically just put whatever we could into it, and going up in the boards today, we just wanted to do our individual dives well, but put them down together, and I think that for the first time, we did a good job of that.
We were more focused on our performance. Yeah. Like, we weren't watching what was going on. We were just like, okay, we need to do this, and we did it. And that's how we dove.
Yeah. Ranked third after the first round of five, the Canadians rattled off three fantastic dives to move comfortably into first place. South Korea would come second. Han Wang and Ying Wang of China rounded out the podium with the bronze. The Canadians very pleased with themselves.
They are pretty dominant, but I think we're catching up. And yeah, like Caroline said, we didn't focus on them, and that was never. We didn't expect to win, and we weren't expecting to beat them. I don't think, but they weren't our focus. Our focus was us.
The last time that Canada had won a medal in diving at the University Games was way back in 1999 in Mallorca. The most successful athlete at Guangzhou was the American swimmer Shannon Vreeland, with 4 gold medals and 1 bronze. In 2012, she got Olympic gold in the 4x200 meters freestyle relay. And here at the World University Games, she was unbeatable over the 100 and 200 freestyle. She certainly came prepared. Here's her team coach, Ray Luza.
We have very, very difficult competition from the young ages all the way up to this point. So they have to really fight for their positions. So this team or the Olympic team or world championships, very difficult to make these national teams. So by virtue of having to be in that pressure pot situation all the time, when they get to a competition like this, they're prepared, comfortable.
Vreeland got gold and silver at her first World University Games in 2011. And here in Guangzhou, she did her bit in the relays again, as the USA took gold in the 4x100 and the 4x200. Altogether in swimming, the Americans grabbed 14 gold medals, partly the result of that impressive university system of theirs.
Well, USA Swimming really believes in the NCAA system, and that's what governs our university system athletically. And from the age 18 to 22, they can study, you know, move on with life in that regard, and get world-class training at the same time, as opposed to only swimming or only studying. And this is the unique part of what the United States has. And, you know, it just allows us to, you know, have, you know, kids that, you know, are here at a high level.
Joshua Pronneau, a member of the American team, demonstrated his strength with 2 gold medals. In the 200 meters individual medley, Pronneau shared top spot with the defending Australian champion Justin James in a dramatic dead heat. And at the 200 meters breaststroke, he beat Japan's Kazuki Koenata to the line. Joshua, very much a product of the American system.
We have a very strong university system. Myself and all the coaches on deck coach at universities all over the country. So we are bringing our athletes and athletes from all over the country to compete here.
Like the women, the men were unbeatable in the 4x100 and 4x200 relays. Altogether, they set a new Games record in the swimming competitions, a total of 41 medals, with the World University Games seen as an important stepping stone on the way to the Olympics.
We have a lot of young, inexperienced swimmers that are fighting for a spot on the Olympic team. We normally bring in about 5 swimmers from here into our Olympic team next year. So they're all getting experience and having a lot of fun.
But there were winners from other countries. The Brazilian, Henrique Martins, has won world relay titles, and he was a silver medalist at the 2011 Universiade in the 4x100 freestyle relay. This time, he got a gold in the 100 meters freestyle, 400ths of a second ahead of one of the Americans, John Conger, Marga Bellotti of Italy, claiming the bronze.
Oh, it's great. last time I've been in the University Games, I was watching the races and I say, one day I want to be in the first place. And 5 years later, I had the chance and I got it, you know, so I'm feeling pretty good right now.
3 days earlier, he'd shot to third place in the world rankings as he powered through the 50 meter butterfly race, a time of 23.22, winning the gold medal in front of the Belarusian Yavhen Turkin and Piero Kodia of Italy. He also took silver in the 50 meters freestyle. Clearly, he's in good shape 1 year before the home Olympics in Rio.
Saw a news last week. 48% of the Olympic medalists had a medal here in University Games. I think that shows how strong this competition is.
Henrique Martins, an outstanding Universiade champion. Could he be a champion at the upcoming Olympic Games as well? We'll see in 12 months' time. A gold medal match in men's water polo between Italy and Hungary. In the fourth period, just 1 minute before the end of the match, Hungary were leading 7-6. But Italy's number 12, Giacomo Lanzoni, equalized to force a penalty shootout. So the Italians hopeful, but Tamás Seidl-Meyer finally settled it in Hungary's favor for a final score of 14-13. In the bronze medal match, the USA beat Serbia 5-4. In the women's final, Canada were against Australia, the Canadians leading 3-2, but then Australia sneaking a goal under the arm of the Canadian keeper, Nicola Coulter-John. Just 2.5 minutes to go at that point. Another penalty shootout then. Elodie Ruffin getting the goal that sealed it in the end for the Australians. Incidentally, the silver medal is Canada's first in women's water polo. Bronze going to Russia after they beat Italy. Onto the rowing, 285 kilometers from Guangzhou, the venue here of the 2013 World Rowing Championships. And Lina Saltytė adding a fourth gold medal for Lithuania, the top rowing nation at the Universiade. The sports coaching student from Kaunas simply too strong for the rest. And beating Ukraine's Natalia Dovgodko by 3.7 seconds. The Dutch rower Marlies Oldenburg in third place. Germany, normally a strong rowing nation, won just one gold medal in the men's Coxless Fours. The Netherlands took silver in this one, beaten by 0.75 seconds. Italy got the bronze.
International University Sports Federation brings together millions of students worldwide around the same values, excellence in mind and body. Thousands of students, hundreds of universities participate in FISU events, the rendezvous for the best student athletes. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.